In our previous video, we discussed the origins of yoga from the Vedic age until the development of Yoga Sutras. Though Patanjali is considered to be the founder of yoga philosophy, he is not the originator of the system. It is acknowledged that Adiyogi or Shiva is said to be the first expounder of this knowledge. Maharishi Patanjali codified this vast Vedic knowledge in the form of sutras for the benefit of the practitioners and hence considered to be the founder of this philosophy. During his period, which is considered as the classical period, focus was given to mindfulness in yoga. Raja Yoga flourished during this time. It was during this time Vedavyasa wrote the first commentary on the Yoga Sutras. If not for his commentaries, the sutras would have remained cryptic and abstract. After classical period, the yoga philosophy continued to evolve. In this video, we shall explore the yogic practices that evolved after the era of Maharishi Patanjali. Post-classical period of yoga can be viewed under the following categories, which gained dominance at various times between 500 AD to 1700 AD. They are the rise of Tantra Yoga and Advaita Vedanta, spread of Tantric practices, and the development of Hatha Yoga from Tantra Yoga. First, we look into the rise of Tantra Yoga. After the era of Maharishi Patanjali, many yoga masters created a system of practices designed to rejuvenate the body and prolong life based on the techniques of Tantra, which is said to be originated during the Vedic age. They rejected the teachings of the ancient Vedas and embraced the physical body as the means to achieve enlightenment. As a result, Tantra Yoga was developed with radical techniques to cleanse the body and create trance and ecstasy among the practitioners. Tantra as a philosophy and set of practices developed extensively among these practitioners, and these were primarily divided into three schools of Tantra lineage based on the deity of worship. Vaishnava, worshipping Vishnu as the primary deity; Shaiva, worshipping Shiva as the primary deity; and Shakti, worshipping Devi or the goddess as the primary deity. The period between 5th century AD to 11th century AD is called the Renaissance period of Vedanta and Tantra. It was during this time Advaita Vedanta thrived under many great masters like Gaudapadacharya and Govindapadacharya. Their teachings influenced Adi Shankara, who was one of the leading masters and the most influential figure in the recent history, who revived and restored the knowledge of Vedanta and also wrote commentaries on Tantric scriptures. Adi Shankaracharya was a proponent of Jnana Yoga and Raja Yoga, and he proposed a 15-fold path, which is based on Patanjali's 8-fold path for the attainment of Samadhi. He travelled extensively across India by foot, spreading his Advaita Vedanta, and participated in philosophical debates with practitioners from other philosophical schools like Mimamsa, and won them. This is known as Shankara Digvijaya. Next, we look into the spread of Tantric practices. By 700 AD, Tantra techniques were being studied in Hindu and Buddhist monasteries across India. Tantra in Kashmir focused on Shiva, and it is known as Shaiva Tantra. It is centered on the writings of great sages Vasugupta and Abhinavagupta. Tantra spread into diverse schools. Sri Vidya School of Tradition is a prominent school among the Tantric schools, which focused on the worship of the Devi or the goddess. From the 8th century to 14th century, Tantric traditions rose to prominence and flourished throughout India and beyond. Next, we look into the development of Hatha Yoga from Tantric techniques. The techniques of Tantra of re-embracing the body and all its energies paved the way for Hatha Yoga to develop. Around 10th century AD, numeric tantric texts on Hatha Yoga began to appear. The system of Hatha Yoga practices was mainly associated with the teachings of Gorakhnath and his teacher Matsyendranath, who is credited with the founding the Shaivanath Sampradaya. The Goraksha Shataka is an early Hatha Yoga text written around the 10th century in the Tantra tradition. The Goraksha Shataka, unlike Ashtanga, the Eightfold Path of Patanjali, describes a system of six limbs of yoga. They are asana, posture, prana samrodha, breath restraint, pratyahara, withdrawal, dharana, concentration, dhyana, meditation, and samadhi. Omitting the first two limbs of Ashtanga, namely the yamas and niyamas, it recommends gradually increasing the breath retention as the best way to samadhi. All of the scriptures on Hatha Yoga were originally based on the tantric techniques. Prominent Hatha Yoga texts are Hatha Yoga Pradipika, dated around 14th century, Shiva Samhita, dated between 15th to 17th century, and Geranda Samhita, dated to late 17th century. The Hatha Yoga Pradipika is a medieval scripture written by the Nath Yogi Swatmarama. It is one of the most detailed manuals describing the techniques of Hatha Yoga. Hatha Yoga is a tantric practice as it attempts to bring about a harmony between the two energies of life, the energies traveling through Ida Nadi and Pingala Nadi. When their union takes place in the central channel, that is the Sushumna Nadi, it is the union of body and mind, and this is the awakening of higher consciousness. It is important to note that Tantra thrived until the Mughal conquest of India between 9th century and 13th century, after which it was completely destroyed, with lineages lost, temples destroyed, and the decline of oral traditions. Now we briefly look into the Bhakti movement which prevailed at that time. The post-classical period of yoga also witnessed teachings of the great acharyas such as Ramanujacharya and Madhvacharya. The teachings of Suradasa, Tulasidasa, Purandaradasa and Mirabai represent great contributions during this period. This was part of the Bhakti movement which rose from southern parts of India and spread across. Bhakti Yoga, described in the Gita as the most accessible and the powerful of the yogas, grew into a widespread movement of its own. It followed the path of surrender to the divine through devotion. To summarize, while Patanjali's yoga is primarily concerned with developing mental concentration in order to experience samadhi, Hatha Yoga develops a system of elaborate and difficult postures and breathing techniques. Hatha Yoga is the system that emphasizes the subtle body, nadis, chakras and kundalini, which it inherited from the tantric tradition. The basic difference between Hatha Yoga and Patanjali's Ashtanga Yoga is that the former involves six limbs of yoga, whereas the latter involves the eight limbs of yoga. Hatha Yoga provides a lot of importance on the practice of physical postures, which leads to a better meditation practice, whereas Ashtanga Yoga focuses on the self-discipline and then moves on to physical postures and meditation. In our next video, we will explore the Hatha Yoga practices that evolved after 17th century, known as the modern period of yoga. Thanks for watching. If you like this content, kindly like and subscribe to my channel. Also, you can now support on patreon.com for the making of more such videos. Samatram Simplified, find your balance with yoga and ancient wisdom.